Hello friends, in this video I will take you through how we can apply virtual keyboard with your ASP.NET web application. Sometimes you have visited many websites like banking applications in which when a user will log in, there will be an option like select a virtual keyboard like this. If I click select virtual keyboard, it will show a virtual keyboard to me. So today we will apply same virtual keyboard in our ASP.NET web application. Now let's flip to Visual Studio. Before we start, I just want to inform you that you don't need to write a code in your notebook. I have provided a link to download a code in the description box, as well as the same video tutorial is available in the form of blog format. I especially want to thank Neeraj for writing such a beautiful blog for it. To apply a virtual keyboard with your ASP.NET web application, you need to download some jQuery files from internet. But if you download the code, all the files are available in a package format. So to apply a virtual keyboard, you need these files. Our first one file that we need is jQuery.keyboard.keypad.js. Another one is jQuery plugin and a minmap file which is already available in a package. To create a virtual keyboard, I took two text boxes. First one is for username, second one is for password. I took one checkbox pair whose ID is virtual keyboard, and I took one button, button submit, and on its click I write down some piece of code. If my username and password will be Dhruvin and 123456, it will redirect to my blog. This is the link for the blog on which all the codes and download links are available. This is the basic UI code which I have written in form tag. Now we want to apply a virtual keyboard on two text boxes. For that, first we need to apply sequence of jQuery files. Remember one thing. First, you must have to load jQuery.min.js. This sequence is very important. If you will skip any of the sequence interchange, then you will not get desired output. Then you have to load a CSS file, jQuery.keypad.cs. Then you have to apply JavaScript file, jQuery.plugin.min.js. Then jQuery.keypad.js, and then we will write our JavaScript code. You can create a separate JavaScript for it, but as of now, for my convenience, I took the code in my script tag. So in document.ready, first I will apply a function whether my checkbox is checked or not. If my checkbox is not checked, then virtual keypad will not open. So that user hashtag username and hash password, which is the ID of username and password text boxes, it will its keypad is destroyed. Otherwise, if my checkbox is checked, then my keypad will virtual keypad will be open. So it will like query layout, and similarly for password, my virtual keypad will be open. Now let's run a code so you will get a better idea. So I am going to run a code. So let's start debug, start without debugging. Look, this kind of page is loaded first. Now if I will not use check this option, use virtual keyboard, it will not open virtual keypad. Now I will write Dhruvin and Dhruvin1234. It will log in successfully. But now I want to open my virtual keypad. Then what I have to do is I have to check it first. Then click on here, it will open my virtual keypad. So I will open my username DHRUVIN, and then if I want to like backspace kind of if I want to remove some character, I can use backspace over here. It will remove characters DHRUVIN. Clear. Now I want to close the virtual keyboard, so I will click here close, and now I will enter a password, that is our password is 1 2 3 4 5 6. Now I will click on submit button. My login is successful and it will redirect me to neerajcodesolutions.com, which is the blog for the same video. Don't worry, I provided a link for the blog. You can find the same thing in the form of blog format. You can download a code from here. You can just click on download now, so you can download a code. And if you really like this video, don't forget to subscribe my channel and share with your friends. If you have any doubt related to this topic or any ASP.NET related concept, you can mail me at dhruvinshah16@gmail.com. Similarly, we are also on WhatsApp. So if you want daily updates from my group, you can request me on WhatsApp. Just write join learn to all and send it to +91 9537 98 1467. Thank you for watching this video.